gi mosula ki nebal mo ko mosula ki nebal mo ko ga tan ci do sa sa dama kay tokke mo kay buli tout sa wa tina mo ko ko nebal mo ko dina nebal mo ko sa ko nebal mo ko that God can do anything. God can do anything in your life. Our duty, our homework, our assignment. Oh, that's a good word. Tell your neighbor, assignment. Our assignment is to stay away from sinful life. Stay clear. Hallelujah. In the olden days, when I'm talking about the old days, that means 20 years ago, when you sail from Suva and you go to the low waters, oh, kamani drawing cost plotting, bikin atori navigation and technical drawing. Kamani drawing ni. Bogi bango, wana kalokalo, namu check taka, namu positioning where they fly. Today we have a global positioning system, the GPS. Salam tuna, Singapore. The GPS at jane miwa, ya moto the kao. Hai yuruzuru na nenya. Ore ni tuna na GPS. Do you know that the Holy Spirit is better than the GPS? Even if you sail to the uncharted waters, the Holy Spirit will guide you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. High five to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, stay away. Stay away from sin. Now, we'll ask the Bible readers, Dr. Ngase Umosi, if you can read again. Read again the Bible verse. We will start with our Bible study now. Now they have revealed mine.
Ia kasangai berata kelebay yang menonggo naka sahwe mengendol uiti dan nakelu kani sasengan iya hong yang nabuk di hunau ia sahwe antine tine nakina na hunau ke iro na profita.
So the law of Moses, it's good, but for salvation, for us to be accepted, it's Jesus. The law is good for our day-to-day life, but going to heaven is through Jesus. Because every one of us sitting here, those who are watching on television, and including the one that is preaching today, we sin, either. Little sin, we sin from time to time, or every time, you know. Every man sin and fall short of the glory of God. Do you believe that? Do you believe that you sinned yesterday? Do you believe that you sinned the day before yesterday? The law keeps us from guiding our life not to sin in every laws, but to be accepted in the family of God in heaven, we need Jesus Christ. We don't need the law, we need Jesus Christ. The law is for us this life. So we are disciplined in what we do. We are very disciplined people. So when Jesus comes, he brings another set of what we call the new revelation. He said, you are the light, can see. You are the salt, can feel. You are the salt of the earth, you are the light of the world. Ruti kena kaya. Iko masih pakai berumura. Iko tidak ada berumura lembut. The world means both physical world and the spiritual world. So you are the light of the world, but you are the salt of the earth. That means salt is about people that they feel that you are very influential, that you are the man of God, that you are the kaltara, that you are the kasiloto, that you are the youth that belong to the church. Amen. Salt of the earth, it's a planet. Salt. Light of the world, that means both in the physical, in the spirit, in the dark, including all the planets, including the galaxy. Do you know that there's about 1 billion galaxy? We are only in one galaxy called Milky Way. We are a galaxy, we are not so close to be burning every day, we are not so far to be ice every day. We are right in the position that God positioned us. And we are the only third planet from the sun. Amen. Amen. So he's sitting here, remember, you are representative of God both in the physical world and also in the spiritual world.